joining us today. We know we have strong competition next door, so we appreciate it even more that you're interested in our topic that we're going to present you today. We're going to talk a little bit about how you address users successfully with dynamic segmentation and how you can personalize your website with dynamic content. And I'm just the technical part of it, and I'm from Turbo. I'm the head of account management at Turbo. My name is Anna. And together with our clients, we're creating personalized experiences on websites of all kinds, but mostly e-commerce clients. And this is why I brought Tobi with me. He's from Galeria Kaufhof, and he's joining me today for this speech.
Yeah, hello everybody. I'm Tobias Roth. I'm from Galeria Kaufhof, and there I'm conversion manager, and I'm responsible for the on-site campaign optimization and everything what's has to do with some personalization and recommendation and also on-site search and the reviews.
Perfect. So let's dive right into it. What are we going to talk about today? First, I want to give you a little bit of an introduction to what segmentation in general, what's dynamic segmentation, which is kind of the next level of segmentation. And then obviously Tobi is going to give a little more insight on how this exactly put into action at a client. And then also give an outview on what are we planning to do in the next months together with Galeria Kaufhof, and just a sum up of what we were discussing today. What's dynamic segmentation or segmentation in general, and why do we need it? Our biggest, let's say, challenge in e-commerce is that there's so many choices and it's so dynamic. So once I want to look for, let's say, a black cocktail dress for a party, I'm going to be presented with multiple choices, thousands of products that I can buy online. And obviously what we want to do as an e-commerce provider, we want to get that client to buy in our store, not in someone else's store. And then there's also this kind of, let's say, opportunity, because there is a possibility that if I buy a dress, I might also buy, it rarely happens, but I might also buy a pair of shoes. So what we also want to do is we not only want to get the client to buy at our store, but we want to get him to buy most of the products, maybe the most expensive products, and that kind of stuff. And let's say, for example, me, I'm going to look for Christmas presents online. And I found a store that I really like, and I find, let's say, a handbag for my mom for Christmas. The next day, I'm going to go there again, and I'm looking for a gift for my boyfriend. I'm buying some, let's say, whatever, a t-shirt. And then the next day, I'm also on that online store, and I'm looking for a present for my best friend. I'm not buying anything. So in between 3 days, my interest in the products that this shop is offering has changed dynamically. And the traditional segmentation cannot keep up with that space, because we're usually looking at demographics. But I'm still from Munich, I'm still female, I'm still 31 years old, my demographics haven't changed, I'm still interested in the same things, and this has nothing to do with what I'm actually looking at. So this is why we need dynamic segmentation in order to, in that moment when I'm on the website and I'm looking at specific products and my behavior is changing, I want to target the user with my specific offer. What does that mean in reality? It means that we need to move away from thinking that we have to have a one-to-one addressing of the users, because that's just an overhead. There's no resources to actually do that. If you imagine you have 100,000 users visiting your website monthly, that would mean you would have 100,000 different approaches to actually target a user, and that's just not possible. So what we want to do, we want to classify users with, for example, the same interests or the same behavior, the same preferences, and then we want to build reasonable, sensible, useful segments that we can target with similar content. In the end, obviously, we're going to use machine learning, so it's kind of a mix of machine learning and human intelligence in order to maximize our, let's say, outcome even more. What's the difference between dynamic segments and static segments? I think static segments are something that most of you probably know and are very used to. It's just clustering people according to what they did before. So let's take, for example, I'm an online store, I'm selling sport clothes, I'm selling sport accessories, equipment, and I'm saying that if someone visited my yoga section, this person is flagged as being interested in yoga products. So once I visited the yoga section, I am a yoga girl, and once I come back to the main site or re-enter the website, my teasering, my offering is targeted towards me buying yoga products. But that's very static. What's the difference with dynamic segments? Dynamic segments are created in real time. That means every click, every visit, every product view can change the segment I'm actually in. So it's very more likely that, for example, impulsive or temporary interests can be taken into account in the decision what is my user interested in right now at this very moment. To make this more clear, because this has been very theoretical, but obviously there's some practical use cases that I think make it more obvious what we're actually doing with our clients, is how can we actually put dynamic segments into effectiveness. One of the, I think, most interesting dynamic segmentation is according to brand affinity, especially if you are a vendor that sells like strong brands, expensive brands, the likelihood of me being interested in a particular brand and then actually really want to buy this particular brand is very high. So what we want to do is we want to tease the client with their favorite brand again and again and again until they actually buy. How can this look like? Very easy example. On the left side, this is the, let's say, main website that I'm going to see when I'm entering the page. This is again an example from sport vendor. So what I see is they are selling, that was in the winter time, they're selling ski equipment, ski clothes, all that kind of stuff. It's not personalized at all. And then I went to the website and I was interested in one particular brand, which is called Shuffle. I spent a lot of time there. I looked at lots of products, but I didn't buy anything yet. I'm leaving the website, I'm coming back again, and instead of seeing the static normal website, I'm actually getting offers from this particular brand where I already shown a very strong interest in. Obviously, this makes it way more easier for me as a user to navigate. I don't have to like search for my brand again. I can directly dive into it. And then also, it's this personalized experience that we want to achieve in any situation where we're buying. I mean, why do you go to your favorite restaurant? Because they know your favorite wine. Why do you go to a boutique instead of the big fashion store? Because they know what you like and they know your size and they just give you the right recommendations. And this is exactly what we want to put into effectiveness in an online store. Another example for dynamic segmentation, this is probably the most, let's say, complex one, is using purchasing behavior, dynamic purchasing behavior. And this is where we need input from our clients, what's actually important for them, like what dynamic purchasing factors are important for the decisions on your website in order to decide if you're going to buy or not. You can take into aspect, for example, how long is a customer staying on the website? How many products has he viewed in detail? How many product detail pages has he viewed? All this kind of actions that a user is doing on the website is taken into consideration. And according to that, we are clustering and we are building segments in real time that are saying someone is more likely to buy this or someone is more likely to buy that. Super interesting, for example, could be, is the person buying rather cheap products or rather expensive products? Because if you're showing expensive products to someone who's only buying cheap or only buying sale, the likelihood of him buying is very low. My favorite example, because everyone is like, this looks very weird. Why is the recommendation looking like this? It is for a reason. As you can see, there is the detail page of a woman handbag. And below that, someone is getting recommendations for a man traditional vest that we're wearing in Munich for the Oktoberfest. At the first, you would be like, why? That doesn't make any sense. It does make sense because this is exactly where temporary and long-term interests come into place. So this user, for example, he's actually a male person, and he was looking for this vest for a very long time, for this vest below here. He didn't purchase yet. He looked at various different product detail pages. He was super interested. He spent lots of time there. And then all of a sudden, he's looking at female handbags. What could that mean? That could mean that his girlfriend's birthday is coming up, and he wants to buy a present for her. That means this is probably rather an impulsive or temporary interest, which is also probably going to be fulfilled very soon, because usually if you buy a present, there's a need, and some when this present needs to be there, otherwise you won't get one. But this interest stays. So if he's going to buy that present anyways at my store, the likelihood of him putting one or even two more products into his basket is higher. We know that. The threshold to actually buy something is very high, but then if you're already buying anyways, you're more likely to buy a second or even third product. So this is on purpose like that, even if it looks strange at the beginning. And we tested this with the client, which is called Lodenfrei, and it worked really, really well. I think this is the plainest use of dynamic segments, and it's also the one that our clients use the most. I think it's the perfect one to start with if you're not sure how I'm gonna actually put this into effectiveness in my own store. I think choosing dynamic segments according to your main category on the website is a very good starting point, because you already have your category listed probably in your navigation, in your header. Choosing our sports store again, I have my different sports in my navigation, like yoga, like football, like basketball, all that kind of stuff. That's my category, and I'm building dynamic segments based on this categories. Not only can we then, like we saw before, for example, change teasers on the website, like the brand ones that you saw, but we could also use that for various different campaigns. In that case, we had a lead generation campaign with a client. So what they wanted to do is they wanted to actually gather email addresses once a client is exiting the website. So once you're showing that you want to exit the website, the lead generation pops up. And it started very plain and simple like this. There was no personalization at all. It was just a form where you could put in your email address, and that's pretty much it. But then we thought, okay, how can we make this more reasonable? How can we make it more personalized for our client? And this was a very specific client, very niche products. He's selling books from law and like all this kind of specific books. And in that case, we created a lead generation that was targeted for different kind of categories that he has on his website. In that case, you see a teaser for labor law. So that means once I've shown interest into labor law, I was flagged by dynamic segments as a user who is interested in labor law. I didn't see the general newsletter that said, please sign up now and you get €5 off. I saw, hey, don't you want to hear more about labor law? You were clearly interested. Sign up now and you will receive information. This can make sense in two ways. First, obviously, there can be different newsletters that you can provide with different information, for example, with content that actually contains labor law. But then also, and I think this is where it's getting really, really interesting, afterwards, we can push this information that we have about this specific dynamic segment into your tracking data, that means into Google Analytics, and you know that this is your segment that was interested into labor law, and you can then use this information, obviously with other vendors, obviously with different campaigns, all kind of information that you want to use it for. Like we have two examples here, and we are working with PhinalLogic for search optimization, and then obviously also with CrossEngage for data orchestration. You can use these segments actually to further orchestrate your data. And I think this is where it's getting really interesting, because probably your data is the most valuable asset that you have, and the most interesting part of your business is what makes you unique, and it's what makes you probably better than your competitors. This is pretty much what it is in theory. And now Tobi is going to show you a little bit how this is done in effectiveness at Kaufhof.
Yeah, thank you. Some numbers about Galeria Kaufhof. Our online store has around 200 to 300 unique visitors per day, and we make in revenue around 350 million euros per year. And so we have a lot of people there, and we have to use segments, because we have products in all categories. We have a lot of fashion, but we also have everything what's on households and sports. So for us, it's a challenge to target the right people. And now we'll start with our first example for segmentation. We have daily deals on Galeria Kaufhof. That means that we have every Tuesday, and so I have to speed up a little bit. A little bit short in time. We have on Tuesday and Sunday, we have special discounts. Now that means we have a set of categories where are discounted. And for us, it's important to show the right people the right discounts. No? We can show everybody every discount, but then it's unlikely that they will purchase. Yeah, And yeah, we had, so there's a detailed example. So last month we had a daily deal where we had 20% discount on watches, suitcase, sports, jackets, women's shoes, and 15% on kitchenware. And yeah, there we had to face the challenge how we can show the right discounts to the right people. And yeah, like Anna said, you can make a one-on-one, yeah, that every people gets his own discount, and it's very in detail, and everybody's talking about personalization, and you know, that every user has to get his own content. But we said, okay, you know, let's wrap it up a little bit and just focus on our main revenue segments. So we made here only three segments, and in the first segments we just made a control group. Where we showed just on the page just Sunday offers up to 20% for everybody, and then made two segments. One segment where we just showed the people who are interested in watches, and the second segment for the people who are interested in sports. And yeah, here you can see how we how it looked graphically on the website. We just used here a small HTML text teaser, so no much effort to put it up. And this one was for the control group. Let's just say Sunday offers and 20% on watch the sports and a lot of more. And then we had our segmentation here. And then we said, okay, for the people who came or who were in our sports or watches categories, we gave them just 20% on watches or 20% on sports. And it doesn't look much, but here in the numbers you can see that that's the control group. What's for everybody there? We had a conversion rate. It was over 450 people, 1,000 people. A conversion rate around 1.3%. And in the first segment where we showed the watches with over 60,000 users, we had a conversion rate that's 1.87. That's a lot of fire. And for the second segment, we even had a conversion rate with 3.3%, and that's more than double of the value for the first segment. So here you can see that if you target the right people, they are more willing to convert a lot, and that's really cool. And what we learn from our segmentation here, you can see that the click-through rate and everything, the revenue, everything is increased in our segmentation campaigns. And the effort is very low to set up such a campaign. So if you just have a small HTML teaser on top, you just go in Turbo and change the wording, change the offer, and put in the right segments. And before we started with our Sunday offers, we made a setup with Turbo where we had our main segments, and now we can just have a look, okay, what are our discounts for this day, and what fits there, what segment we can choose. So just take a segment, put it in the right campaign, change the wording, and everything is done. And so not much work, but a lot of increased revenue and everything. Yeah, and overall, it's difficult to say overall conversion upgrade, but it's around 20% for the campaigns. Yeah, what are other learnings? Like I said before, it's very easy to set up. You can reduce your campaigns. You don't need any graphic elements. It's just a small text element. The people don't get disturbed from the rest of the page. And so, okay, we have 5 minutes left. I think I have 10 more pages to show here. So it's... don't know really how to manage this here.
Maybe we're skipping one example.
Yeah, I think we will skip one example. The It just wrap it up here really fast. No, we had before Christmas we had three campaigns, and here we had a mix of campaigns where we showed discounts, and the other were just for services. So we at Kaufhof we have a lot of stores in Germany, so the people can also shop and pick from store, we call it. And we want to show the users that even if it's after the 21st and you can't buy online because your present won't be there at Christmas, you can just pick it up from the store, the delivery. And that's a really cool feature, but we also wanted to show the people, our customers, that we have a 15% discount on a lot of categories at this time. And we also had a payback campaign at this time, and also wanted to show the people who are interested in payback also the right campaigns. And here you can see the service discount, also just a small banner. We also have here an exit intent, also made with Turbo. And here's the payback campaign. And we had a segmentation on the payback users, so every referral and everywhere we had payback on the site, and the people were there, they get into the segmentation of payback. And also our favorite discount was filled by the categories the people visited. And Christmas service, we thought that, okay, it's only worth to show people who are more than had three page impressions, because it's more important to show the discount to keep the people on the site. In the numbers you can see the conversion rate for the favorite discount and Christmas service is it's the same, but we had a really great increase in the conversion rate for the payback user. So it's just a very small amount of users in comparison to 3 million, but it's worthwhile because it's a very simple setup. Now we use this every day, the payback segmentation, not only for Christmas. And once you set it up, you just can run it on your site, and it's working. So what's next at Kaufhof? What are our challenges, and on what projects are we focusing here? The first thing is that we take data from different tools and put it into Turbo. So we have a recommendation engine who puts this data into Turbo. We can use our testing tools and put also the data into Turbo. So that's really cool because you have the data from different sources. So it's very valuable for the users, and you can increase the revenue, also the conversion rate and everything very much. Mapping is not every time easy, because you have to clear up your data. If one tool uses woman and the other uses Damen, you can't match it, and you have very strict focus on your data, and basically make a CDP and increase your data. Okay, go on there or
yeah
okay.
2 minutes.
The other important thing, like Anna showed on the shuffle, on the sports side there, that we also want to show our teasers with dynamic segmentation. So if I'm on watches and go one day later back to the homepage on Galeria Kaufhof, the main teaser and the header should also be the watches header. Now it's just a normal header. Yeah. So. And we also have an inspiring site that's also done with Turbo. It's called Shop the Look, and there we show our outfits with a bundle of fitting other products to them. So if you have the right handbag with the right shoes and the whole outfit, and the people are willing to buy more products if they see a whole bundle of products. And we can also use the segmentation here to get the people in our shop look section. So if I'm on our homepage, the people are interested in shopping and women clothes, we show them a layer. Now go to our shopping section or our outfit section here and have a look. And yeah, it's a really cool conversion driver. Yeah, here that's the man section for the shopping. And now we also have home section, and yeah, there we have the challenge that it's not only fashion, men's and women. So we have a bunch of products, and it's difficult to find out what interests the people are or have based on their behavior on the site.
Okay. Quick and dirty summary. What did we learn today? We learned there's a difference between static and dynamic segmentation. We also learned that if we're going to create reasonable segmentations, we can increase our turnover, our conversion rates, our click-through rates, and whatever is your goal on your business side. What else did we learn? We can learn that dynamic segments can be built by different factors that you can actually decide on. For example, it could be how deep is a user searching on your website, which time is the user spending on your website, brands, categories, whatever is interesting for us. We also learned that a segment should have a reasonable size. Obviously, if you target 5 users, that probably doesn't make that much sense. But we also learned that if you have a reasonable amount, for example, 2,000 people that are interested in the payback campaign that Toby showed, it can have such a high conversion rate uplift that it might be reasonable to target a specific group. And that's it. Yeah.